the organizers for the invitation and to give me the chance to come to this great country and meet with you guys here in Greece. My topic is related also to Alzheimer's disease, and actually, while we had now an introduction about Alzheimer and dementia, so in our case, we wanted to understand the mechanism by which extra virgin olive oil and oleocanthal actually can affect the Alzheimer's disease pathology and the possibility and to understand how it can protect against Alzheimer's disease. So when we talk about Alzheimer's disease, it is the most common form of dementia. It is characterized by several hallmarks, sorry. And those are related to, as you can see here, it is related to the increased level of beta-amyloid that you heard about just now. And we have the tau hyperphosphorylation, and they found that actually the tau, which is also important for the neuronal cells, actually they will get hyperphosphorylation and affect the neuronal cell function. In addition to that, you will find also astrogliosis, neural dystrophy, and neuronal loss, in addition to some vascular alteration. Maybe all this, I summarized it here in the figures below, where you can see here, now, according to what we, at least in my laboratory, we believe is that Alzheimer's disease has some vascular component where when the blood-brain barrier function, and I will tell you a little bit about blood-brain barrier in the coming slides, that when there are some disturbances in the blood-brain barrier, this will allow for the decreased function of the BBB to protect the brain. This can allow for increase in the beta-amyloid levels that you can see it here, resulting in a plaques formation, in addition to formation of a neurofibrillary tangles that are associated with the tau hyperphosphorylation. And this can result further in neuronal death that can further lead to the this side of the brain that can show as atrophy or kind of a reduction in the size of the brain. Now, since we are talking about the blood-brain barrier, just to show you and just to envision the blood-brain barrier here, so if you can see, this is the brain, and these red vessels here are kind of formed from, you have the blood vessel that is, in these blood vessels, you will find that composed of endothelial cells here, in addition to the presence of other brain cell components, and this all together, we will call it the neurovascular unit. However, for us, we are focusing on the blood-brain barrier that is can be seen in this slide here, and that we believe that oleocanthal and Evo targets these. The blood-brain barrier and these cells. Now, why the blood-brain barrier? Because several studies showed and related that in Alzheimer's disease patients, they found that there are some disturbances in the function and the integrity of the blood-brain barrier. Now, if this is here, if this is here in a kind of represent the healthy vessel, now, in Alzheimer's disease patients, you will find that due to the accumulation of beta-amyloid on the vascular unit, you will find that this will result in the disruption, and this can result in dysfunctional blood-brain barrier. Now, you heard about beta-amyloid. Beta-amyloid, it is produced from this here protein, large protein, that when it is broken down by multiple enzymes, it will produce beta-amyloid that can further, if the level increases, it can further accumulate, aggregate and accumulate and form deposit. Now you will find that this side here is what is known as the amyloidogenic pathway. So this pathway here that results in the formation of the toxic peptide, which is beta-amyloid. Now also from the same routine, you will find that there is another pathway where it will allow for the hydrolysis of this protein from a different region that avoid the production of beta amyloid. So from the same protein, you will find that there is the amyloidogenic pathway, production of beta-amyloid and the non-amyloidogenic pathway that results in the formation of different proteins. Now, we are talking about the blood-brain barrier. So this is just to simplify the blood-brain barrier. Those are the endothelial cells. This here is the brain side, and this is the blood side. Now, at the blood-brain barrier, or the endothelial cells of the blood-brain barrier, you will find that there are several proteins that are expressed there. So those proteins are very important to maintain when they are functional and expressed at the right level. They are very important to maintain the function and the integrity of the blood-brain barrier. Now, I will focus here on some of the proteins that are related to beta-amyloid. Now, we have here what is known as the low-density lipoprotein 1, and we have here what is known as the P-glycoprotein, and those are some degrading enzymes. Now, these proteins here, they are very important for the removal or clearance of beta-amyloid from the brain to the blood. These proteins here are responsible for the degradation, for the breakdown of beta-amyloid. Now, when we talk about aging and also in Alzheimer's disease, it is reported by other investigators, in addition to our studies, we showed that actually these proteins are down-regulated, or they are decreasing with aging and also in Alzheimer's disease. So because of this reduction in these proteins, you will find that if these proteins are down-regulated, this will result in the decrease in the clearance of beta-amyloid from the brain to the blood. That results in further accumulation, deposits or plaques formation of beta-amyloid that are deposited in the parenchyma, in addition to that deposit at the blood vessels of the blood-brain barrier, and that's what we call vascular A-beta deposit. So here with aging and in Alzheimer also, you will find that those proteins functions are decreased, allow for less clearance of beta-amyloid, and thus their deposit. Now, the higher the levels of beta-amyloid, the more the toxic is the effect. Now, from our studies, we found that there are multiple pathways for beta-amyloid clearance from the brain. So either across the blood-brain barrier, or by degradation in the brain, or via the CSF or the cerebrospinal fluid. Now, we found that actually the blood-brain barrier has the highest contribution to the clearance of beta-amyloid, which make it an important target in order to develop drugs that can improve its function, and thus it can improve the clearance and hopefully can prevent or halt the disease. Now, in order for us to know the contribution of the blood-brain barrier, and especially with the two proteins that we are talking about that are P-glycoprotein and LRP1, we did some experiments that, inhibition studies rather, in order to measure the contribution of these proteins. And when we did some inhibition studies with two of blockers of P-glycoprotein and LRP1, we found actually, yes, by blocking these two pathways, beta-amyloid clearance decreased from about 40% to about 20%. So the idea here from this slide that there are two proteins that are very important for the clearance of beta-amyloid, that with aging and Alzheimer's disease, they are down-regulated. So if we target these proteins, that we upregulate them, then in this case, maybe we can enhance the clearance of beta-amyloid, and hopefully we can find some kind of approach to treat the disease. Now, of course, we all know that for Alzheimer has no treatment. And in order for us to treat the disease, certainly we have to focus what targets we have, or what is that we have to target and as a therapeutic approach. So in this case, for our case, we are talking about the blood-brain barrier. We are searching for molecules that can enhance the clearance of beta-amyloid. And we, in this case, we thought about searching the literature. Now, while we are working also with other molecules, however, when we wanted to go for diet and searching the literature, we found that actually with sticking to Mediterranean diet, or the publications literature indicated that sticking to the Mediterranean diet can improve the cognitive function in patients. So we thought, what is the most component of the Mediterranean diet? And we obviously it is extra virgin olive oil. It is one of the those components that are the main component of the Mediterranean diet. So we thought, if we can, how about we try administering this EVON and see whether it will affect the pathology of Alzheimer's disease and understand the mechanism. If it improves the cognitive function, what is the mechanism by which EVO or extra virgin olive oil can improve this function? So, and because we are talking about mechanisms, so of course we used animal animals for the experiments. And for these experiments, we used one of the available olive oil, extra virgin olive oil available in the market. And first, before applying or using it to our experiments, we did some analysis using high-resolution mass spectrometry as well as some HPLC work in order to quantify oleocanthal level as well as oleuropein-aglycone. And this is the level that we found in the oil we used in the subsequent studies. Now, this is the study design. For these experiments, we use an animal model for Alzheimer's disease, and it is known here, it is the TGSWDI. It is a transgenic animal that expresses the pathology of Alzheimer's disease. So what we did here, we divided our animals into three groups. One group was in control food. Another group that was, we started treating these animals at the age of 4 months for 3 months. So we started at 4 months of age and ended at 7 months of age. And we had, and the idea here that we started at 4 months because we wanted to see if the pathology already started and we introduced EVON, is it able to treat the disease? And for the other group, which is EVO with 6 months, we started the treatment at 1 month of age. So we wanted here and continued for 6 months and until the age of 7 months. Now, the idea here that we wanted to see whether EVO, at, when we start the treatment before the onset of the disease, whether it will be able to prevent it or not. And then at the 7 month of age, the animals were sacrificed and we collected the brains for analysis. Now, we performed an experiment that where we administered here exogenous beta-amyloid in order to measure its clearance, to measure the effect of EVON on the blood-brain barrier that we talked about earlier. So what we found here, actually using this modified method by us, we found actually that EVON was able to increase the clearance of beta-amyloid from the brain across the blood-brain barrier. Now, our hypothesis was related to increase the proteins that are related to this clearance. So which means here, if we increase this, and we increase this at the blood-brain barrier here, or the endothelial cells of the blood-brain barrier, this will allow for enhanced clearance. So what happened here, actually, yes, we were able, or EVO was able to increase these two proteins. Increasing these proteins allowed for the higher clearance of beta-amyloid. And we confirmed that these two proteins increased by the experiment here, where you can find that. For example, this is for the first protein, there is induction here or increase in the level, as well as for the second protein where there is increase in the level. These are in the brain capillaries or the brain vessels of these mice. Now, in addition to increasing the clearance across the blood-brain barrier also, here, one of the most toxic moieties in the brain of Alzheimer's disease patients, there are what is called beta-amyloid oligomers. When you have more than monomers of beta-amyloid come in aggregation to form what is called oligomers. Now, those oligomers are toxic. So we wanted to see whether EVO treatment actually can reduce these oligomers. So what we did, we analyzed the brain that been collected, and we measured the effect of EVO on the oligomers levels. So what we found, actually, treatment for 6 months with EVO at early age was able to reduce these toxic oligomers of beta-amyloid, and however, this effect was not seen with the treatment group, which is for 3 months. Also, again here, this is a section from the brain, where is the hippocampus is shown. Now, this green color here represents the beta-amyloid deposits. And this is for control food. This is for 3 months treated animals with EVOL, and this is for 6 months. You can see here, compared to the control, that there is a reduction on the, in the beta-amyloid levels in the brains, indicative that beta-amyloid reduced the levels of deposited and available beta-amyloid in the brain of these animals. Now, in addition, we mentioned about tau hyperphosphorylation at the beginning, and we said that in the brain of Alzheimer's disease patients that we could detect the neurofibrillary tangles that are formed because of the hyperphosphorylation of tau. Now, these tau proteins are very important for the structure of the neuron. When they are hyperphosphorylated, the structure of the neuron will collapse. That results in formation of neurofibrillary tangles. Now, another mechanism by which EVO can work, it reduce the hyperphosphorylation of tau, and actually this effect was better observed with the 6 months treatment compared to the 3 months treatment, indicative that if we start before the onset of the disease, this can improve the pathology or decrease the pathology associated with Alzheimer's disease. In addition to these two, so clearance of beta-amyloid, decrease hyperphosphorylation of tau, EVO could work also in decreasing the production of beta-amyloid. Maybe you can, if you remember at the beginning when I showed you that this protein, the ABB protein, that can go either into toward the production of beta-amyloid or the other way where it avoid the production of beta-amyloid. EVO, from the studies and the experiments we did, we showed that EVO was able to reduce the beta amyloid production and increase this non-amyloidogenic pathway. So as you can see here, when we measured it at 6 months treatment, we found that EVO was able to reduce beta amyloid production and increase the other side of the processing of APP. And this means when you decrease the beta amyloid production, you will have less of that toxic protein available in the brain, and thus it will decrease its deposit. Now, we did simple kind of behavior studies to measure the cognitive function, and we found again with 6 months treatment of EVO, we found that the cognitive function of these mice was improved compared to the control mice that was fed with food, with control food. And also we found that starting a treatment after the pathology starts actually didn't enhance or improve the function of in these mice, the cognitive function. So obviously here that we can say that maybe that if we, the long-term intake of evolve before the onset of the disease, this can prevent or at least to halt the disease according to the results of this study. Now, because we are also interested in oleocanthal being one of the major components in extra virgin olive oil, so we thought about how if we try and to identify whether that positive effect that been observed with extra virgin olive oil is related to oleocanthal. So we conducted similar studies with oleocanthal in transgenic animals of Alzheimer's disease model. Now we, for the extraction of oleocanthal, we used our published paper available already in the literature in collaboration with our, one of the faculty in my department, Dr. Sayed, who extracted oleocanthal according to his established procedure in the literature. Now again, now very important to know here that when we started this experiment, we didn't know what dosage to give these animals because we were actually the first to introduce or to give oleocanthal in vivo in order to test its effect in animals. So we tried at the beginning to give different doses and monitor the bioavailability of oleocanthal in these mice. However, it was very difficult, as Dr. Lee indicated in his presentation. It was very difficult to monitor and see oleocanthal, and thus we decided to go for a single dose, which is 5 mg/kg per day, and we gave this oleocanthal dose for 4 weeks. Now, we followed the same procedure. We, after the administration of oleocanthal for 4 weeks, we conducted some clearance studies, and then we sacrificed the animals for some brain analysis. Now, again, oleocanthal enhanced the clearance of beta-amyloid across the blood-brain barrier, and this enhancement was associated with the increase in the proteins that are responsible, or major proteins that are responsible for its clearance, that are here, P-glycoprotein and LRP1. In addition to that, oleocanthal also increased the proteins that are responsible for the breakdown of beta-amyloid, that as can be seen in these two proteins. This one with the oleocanthal compared to the control, and this is with oleocanthal compared to the control. So actually, there are two pathways for enhancing the clearance by oleocanthal. It is by the enhancement of clearance across the blood-brain barrier, as well as by enhancing the clearance through the degradation of increasing the expression of the two enzymes responsible for the degradation of beta-amyloid. Again, you can see here that oleocanthal decreased beta-amyloid deposit, and you can see here the green color is for beta-amyloid, and you can see with oleocanthal this green staining here, which is representative for beta-amyloid, actually decreased with the oleocanthal treatment. In addition, interestingly here, we found also, in addition to reduction in parenchymal or in the brain level of beta-amyloid, also we found that there is a reduction in the vascular level of beta or deposits of beta-amyloid. So this is with the control treated animals. This is with oleocanthal. Now, the green color here represents the beta-amyloid that you can see here significantly reduced, and the red color here represents the brain vessels, where you can see that beta-amyloid, where it is deposited. So you can see that with the treatment of oleocanthal, we have reduction in that vascular deposit. In addition to clearance across the blood-brain barrier, by degradation and decreasing vascular amyloid, beta amyloid. Also, there is another pathway for clearance of beta amyloid, and it is known as the ApoE-dependent clearance pathway. So this pathway include or involve multiple proteins. You have here ABCA1, you have ApoE, you have BBR-gamma, in addition to other proteins that we measure. So what we found that oleocanthal treatment in these mice increased this proteins, this protein which is responsible for the regulation of ABCA1 that also increased. This protein is important to transfer cholesterol to what is known as apolipoprotein E, results in lipidation of this protein. The lipidation of this lipoprotein is important for the clearance of beta-amyloid. So this is increasing, results in this increase, lipidation of ApoE, which also increases, and this results in cell degradation or microglial degradation of beta-amyloid. Now, when this pathway is activated, this will result in decrease in deposit of beta-amyloid, and thus this will reduce also the toxicity. So this is an additional mechanism by which oleocanthal can decrease the deposition or accumulation of beta-amyloid in the brain. Now, when it comes to beta-amyloid production, treatment for 4 weeks with oleocanthal in these mice actually didn't affect the production of beta-amyloid. Now, it could be either related to the short period that oleocanthal being given to the animals, or maybe it could be affected by other components that are provided by the extra virgin olive oil given in the previous study. Now, in addition to those, another mechanism that oleocanthal could target here is that, now, this is just to explain what you see in Alzheimer's disease patients, that there is what is known as the astrogliosis. Astrocytes are another cells that are expressed in the brain. In normal brain, this is the astrocytes, how they look. However, upon activation because of beta-amyloid, you will find that they become different in shape and bigger. So in this case, this is also related to the production of inflammatory, or what are known as cytokines. So those cytokines are toxic, actually, that are produced by the astrocytes are toxic to the neurons. So knowing this fact, we wanted to see the effect of oleocanthal on these active astrocytes, in addition, and the levels of the cytokines that are produced by these astrocytes when they are activated. Now, what we found here, that actually oleocanthal treatment was able to reduce the activation of these astrocytes. So this is the control group, and this is the oleocanthal treatment group. Now, here in this small square, you will find that in control mice, you will have activated astrocytes indicative of the pathology of the disease. However, with the treatment of oleocanthal, you can find that the astrocytes could take its normal or close to normal shape as in the absence of the Alzheimer. And this was associated with reduction in beta-amyloid levels, and this can be shown in this quantification here. And also, in addition to the decreased activation of astrocytes, you will find that also the production of cytokines, like an example here is interleukin 1 beta, actually it was significantly reduced as a function of, or as due to the treatment with oleocanthal. So to conclude for these results, we can say that long-term consumption of EVO and adding it to the diet could provide protective effect against Alzheimer's disease. Also, we can say that oleocanthal is this a novel natural molecule that can or have multiple protective effects or mechanisms by which it can protect and or halt the progress of Alzheimer's disease, and can provide a potential effective therapeutic that need to be considered. And of course, finally, I would like to thank my graduate students who are doing all this work, and I would like to thank my collaborators in addition to my funders. Also, I would like to thank the governor producers because they are supporting me and providing us with the olive oil that we are currently using in our two current ongoing studies to investigate other mechanisms. And thank you very much.